You know, the whole premise with the XR650L was to see what we could really do on a budget. With the 650L, we had a chance to get into a bike that's a fairly low entry price. We put some mods on it to see if we really could create a budget adventure bike. So when we got our bike, there were a couple of things that we needed to address. First one right up here in front was the suspension. This bike is sprung and valved really soft. The front end had a lot of dive under braking, so we took that up to Precision Concepts, let Bob Bell do his thing. The other thing I personally had the biggest issue with was the stock handlebar mounting. Bars sit very far back in the stock position and had a lot of sweep. These Rock Speed bar risers are perhaps the single greatest mod that I found for this bike. As you can see, this moves the bars not only forward but up and gives a super comfortable riding position both for standing and for just sitting down on the highway. We got our flex bars on here. These are the 14 degree adventure bike bend, super comfortable. And then our Slipstreamer windscreen. This was almost an afterthought to me. And once we put it on, I have become such a fan of it. It really provides some protection from wind blasts going down the highway. The other great thing about the mounting, it was a little bit of a challenge with the flex bars, but we used their oversized bar mounts and got it right on. The cool thing is, two thumb screws on this and it comes off in seconds. For any long-term riding, great addition to the comfort on the bike. We tried a couple of different configurations on the exhaust. Here we're looking at the Stalker. We also ran with the FMF full system that had the Q4 silencer and the power bomb header. I really like the FMF for performance. I really like just the stealthy quality of the stock silencer, being able to chug around town, not make any noise. Up here in the carb, you can't really see it, but we put the FMF jetting kit in there. That was the single biggest improvement in the performance because the stock jetting is so lean that the bike is almost unrideable the way it comes off the showroom floor. Our Clark tank, this has got to be just about the slimmest 4-gallon tank I've ever used. Basically, that's taken our range from the 80-90 mile distance clear up to a pretty comfortable 150. Promoto billet rack, it proves itself every day. Anytime you want to run to the store, do an errand, carry something around, there you got a real easy place to strap something to. Inside the airbox, we've got the No Toil Supercharger filter system, which is a cage and foam filter to replace the paper filter that comes stock in this. All of the smog paraphernalia is gone. We bought a block off kit off eBay of all places, and that was only a few dollars to install. Definitely took a little bit of work to get it all together though. Stock tires that came on this thing, the Dunlops, were pretty pathetic, so we tried a couple of different setups. On here right now, we've got the King's tire, which I do not like. I think all in all, I would have to say probably the best all-around tire I can think of for this bike would be the Dunlop 606. It gets good wear, pretty decent performance on the street, and still usable in the dirt. So there's a quick look at some of the performance modifications we've made to our XR650L project bike, and it's an inexpensive bike to own and use, and that's got to be one of the greatest attributes of this bike is just how user-friendly it is, and it's a bike you can get a lot of miles on without breaking the bank.